Hi guys, my name is Josh and you're watching my DIY channel video EPPO. Now all of you know that this is a weight balance. It's a very simple device that we use in our everyday life. So the weight goes on one side and then you add your commodities on the other side. It's gonna take a while. Hang on with me a bit. Okay. Now when you strike a balance, a bit heavy on this side. When you strike a balance, you have a D. But my question is, will this device work if I have to cut one side of this thing off? Now, can you get this to work? Answer to that question is going to come right after the intro. Keep watching. Welcome back everybody. Today we have so many different kinds of scale balance and you could see a wide variety of them in the marketplaces. In fact, you get small scales like this that is used in the kitchen, and these are called as kitchen scales, and I have one for my personal use as well. Now getting back to our question, will this gadget work if I had to remove one side of this balance? The answer is yes, but it needs some kind of a tweaking. The inspiration comes from a vegetable vendor, and I shot this clip about a year ago. Have a look at it. Now this small vegetable vendor could have used a spring balance or a regular balance for that matter, but his idea was different and that peculiarity caught my attention. How does he do it? It's because of center of gravity. And I think now it's time to play with some forks and a glass.
Grab a set of forks and interlock its fangs facing each other. It should lock firmly, but if it doesn't, don't hesitate to drop a dab of super glue in there. Then a toothpick can be inserted in between one of the fangs. Now this arrangement can be balanced on the glass edge by placing the toothpick on the glass. It definitely works, but be patient till you get it right. Note that the forks are oddly arranged, but the center of gravity is on the toothpick at a certain point. Once it's balanced, you can go ahead and burn the rest of the toothpick. And surprisingly, it would only burn till the point that is resting on the glass. You can see it clearly here. Now this could be shifted anywhere you like and it's going to stay balanced at this point. This was a very quick example of knowing and understanding the center of gravity. Now to get back to our project, we need a dowel 1 inch in thickness. This is a part of a kitchen mop and I'm sure you can find one too. For the record, I'm weighing it and it's close to 80 grams. Let's first tie the pan to one end of this dowel. Then let's loop a thread which needs to be tied to the dowel. This is a simple knot which could be loosened when required and slided on the dowel.
You can now see that the weight is on this side. So what we are going to do is, we are going to shift the fulcrum a little towards this end. Not even yet. Now the weight is on this side, so there is going to be a little bit of push and pull till you hit the right spot. We're almost there. A little bit of tweaking. This is not going to be very perfect, but we have it.
I'm scoring a small groove on the dowel for the loops to sit comfortably.
Now you can see that even without the other side of the balance, if you rearrange the pivot point or the fulcrum point, the center of gravity changes and the system balances itself. Now the task is to add some weight and keep shifting this center point and see the system balances itself.
I began by measuring 100 grams of rice and I'm going with the increments of 100 grams. After measuring 100 grams, you can place this on the pan and then try to balance it again. By repeating the previous process and shifting the pivot, we get the system to balance. The idea here is to get the dowel parallel to the ground. Then the weight was increased to 200 grams and balanced again. The point of pivot was marked and I repeated the process all the way up to 500 grams, that is half a kilo. And it worked!
when I Google for this kind of balance, I learned that these kind of balance are called as steelyard balance, and I might have to do a little bit of more learning on that. In the steelyard balance, the fulcrum doesn't move, but we are actually moving the fulcrum point from one point to another point and adjusting the weight. That is the only difference that is there in this particular balance that we've made and the steelyard balance.
With each increment of 100 grams, I kept marking on the dowel, and now this is all said to be used as a weight balance. It might not be accurate, but the job gets done.
I'm not saying that this system is perfect, but with this system, you can actually measure from 100 grams to 500 grams on the increments of 100 grams. This is a hack, and in India we call hack as jugaad, and I'm happy to learn this jugaad art from a vegetable vendor who actually taught me some basic concepts of physics. I really thank him for being the inspiration of this video. I hope you like this video. I'll be back with another interesting and entertaining episode next week. Until then, bye. Oh.